The little six-legged inhabitants, insects of the planet Earth, have always been given a back seat, partly because of their small size that leads to their inconspicuous existence. However, in terms of diversity, abundance, and biomass, they conquer this Earth. Of all the living organisms on Earth that scientists have described, more than two-thirds are insects. For every human on Earth, there are about 200 million insects, and insect biomass is 300 times more than that of humans. Hence, it is the number that matters in insects and not size. In view of their numbers, they are not only ecologically, but also economically important in the ecosystems. This can be viewed in two aspects, beneficial and non-beneficial to mankind. Many insects, such as bees, butterflies, and flies, are important pollinators. Some 75% of the world's crop species depend on pollination, mostly by insects. When crops can't reproduce, humans and animals will lose the key food sources. Insects are in almost every food chain. Birds, bats, amphibians, and fish feed on insects before they in turn are eaten by other predators. Therefore, species that are higher up in the food chain will suffer population losses. Fascinating insects such as butterflies, dragonflies, and fireflies contribute significantly to nature tourism and environmental education. Insect watching is gaining momentum in many countries as it promotes healthy lifestyle among the younger generations who are always glued to the smartphones and computers. Dung beetles, flies, termites, and ants are important decomposers. They turn waste, carrion, and other decaying materials into nutrients that can be taken up by plants. Naturally, some predatory insects help in controlling pest populations in agriculture and forestry, performing the role of pesticides without chemical. In other aspects, dragonflies, which are also known as mosquito hawks, control the population of mosquitoes and flies, which are vectors of diseases to humans. Insects are used extensively in genetic studies, forensic science, and environmental studies. Certain insects or their secretions were proven to be of some value in the treatment of certain human ailments such as apitherapy and maggot therapy. Some beautiful insects have aesthetic values. Butterflies, moths, and dragonflies are pleasing to humans, which provide inspiration and environmental therapy. On the other hand, some insects are detrimental to humans. They damage agriculture crops, forest trees, and livestock. Termites cause substantial damage to wooden structures and furniture, especially in the tropics. Mosquitoes, flies, and roaches have adversely affected the health and livelihood of many people because of the diseases that they transmit. Now, lately, there has been a growing concern among scientists on the global insect decline. This was featured in the recent National Geographic and a number of high-impact scientific journals. Habitat fragmentation, land use changes for agriculture and urbanization, indiscriminate use of pesticides and other forms of pollution, forest fire, as well as global climate change contribute to the global insect decline. These have also caused ecosystem imbalance, which leads to proliferation of certain robust species that eventually cause outbreak, like the recent swarming of migratory locusts in Africa and adjacent countries. We are moving towards a biodiversity crisis. In view of the impending more severe dilemma, it is utmost important that we practice responsibility and sustainability for Mother Nature towards a better environment for a greener world. With that, I'm Arthur Chung, the senior entomologist at the Sabah Forestry Department, signing off here. Thank you for watching.